What is OSI reference model and OSI layers? OSI, Open Systems Interconnection. OSI is reference model for how applications can communicate over a network. A reference model is a conceptual framework for understanding relationships. The purpose of the OSI reference model is to guide vendors and developers so the digital communication products and software programs they create will interoperate and to facilitate clear comparisons among communications tools. Developed by representatives of major computer and telecommunication companies beginning in 1983, OSI was originally intended to be a detailed specification of actual interfaces. OSI layers. The main concept of OSI is that the process of communication between two endpoints in a telecommunication network can be divided into seven distinct groups of related functions or layers. Each communicating user or program is at a computer that can provide those seven layers of function. So, in a given message between users, there will be a flow of data down through the layers in the source computer, across the network, and then up through the layers in the receiving computer. The seven layers of function are provided by a combination of applications, operating systems, network or device drivers, and networking hardware that enable a system to put a signal on a network cable or out over Wi-Fi or other wireless protocol. The seven open systems interconnection layers are: number 1, physical layer; 2, data link layer; 3, network layer; 4, transport layer; 5, session layer; 6, presentation layer; and 7, application layer. Number 1, physical layer. This layer conveys the bit stream through the network at the electrical, optical, or radio level. It provides the hardware means of sending and receiving data on a carrier network. Number 2, data link layer. This layer sets up links across the physical network, putting packets into network frames. This layer has two sublayers, the logical link control layer and the media access control layer. Ethernet is the main data link layer in use. Number 3, network layer. This layer handles the addressing and routing of the data, sending in it in the right direction to the right destination on outgoing transmissions and receiving incoming transmissions at the packet level. IP is the network layer for the internet. Number 4, transport layer. This layer manages packetization of data, then the delivery of the packets, including checking for errors in the data once it arrives. On the internet, TCP, Transmission Control Protocol, and UDP, User Datagram Protocol, provides these services for most applications as well. Number 5, session layer. This layer sets up, coordinates, and terminates conversations. Services include authentication and reconnection after an interruption. On the internet, Transmission Control Protocol and User Datagram Protocol provide these services for most applications. Number 6, presentation layer. This layer is usually part of an operating system and converts incoming and outgoing data from one presentation format to another. For example, from clear text to encrypted text at one end and back to clear text at the other. Number 7, application layer. This is the layer at which communication partners are identified, network capacity is assessed, and that creates a thing to send or opens the things received.